Hello and welcome back to Creative PowerPoint. Today, we'll walk through the creation of this text animation. It's inspired from the discipline called motion graphics, the art of using animated graphics to inform, influence, or entertain. Are you ready? Let's go! Our human brain is wired to pay attention to movement, especially fast one with sudden change of speed and direction. In the early days of humanity, reacting quickly to danger could make the difference between life and death. Motion graphics uses that human sensitivity to movement to retain the audience's attention. Let's create the text entrance animation. Many of you probably know that PowerPoint has an animation called Fly-In. It's very easy to set up, but it gives a boring movement. Instead, we'll use a special mode of the morph transition used to animate characters. Let's start with a basic example. On an empty slide, let's add a text box. In our case, it will contain the word arts. Let's duplicate the slide, and in the second slide, replace the word by an anagram, star. Let's go to the transition tab and add the morph transition. At this stage, nothing particularly exciting happens. But if I go to the transitions effect option and choose character instead of object, we can see that PowerPoint will animate each letter individually. PowerPoint also handles cases where the letters are not exactly the same in the two slides. For example, let's replace art by heart in the first slide. You can see that PowerPoint fades in and out the missing or extraneous letters. Let's use this property to generate this deceleration effect. Let me replace the word on the second slide by creative. On the first slide, I also write the word creative, but I insert tab between letters. Between the two last letters, I'll press the tab key once to add one tab. Immediately to the left, I'll add two tabs, then three tabs, and so on. Let me do the same thing with another word, PowerPoint. But this time, I'll add more tabs as I go to the right. Let's zoom out to better see what we have. Let's move the first text box to the left, outside of the slide visible area. And let's move the second text box to the right. Let's check that we have the morph transition active on characters and run the transition. It's interesting, but not exactly what we want. As you can see, one letter E has moved from the top world to the bottom world. This happens because PowerPoint tries to optimize the movement of each letter individually, so that every letter moves the least amount possible. In my case, shifting the word creative to the left on the second slide was sufficient to force PowerPoint to choose a different animation strategy. It may take some fiddling to find the right combination. In my experience, I found that making all words appear from the same side is easier. We've animated our entrance. Let's now add the halo effect. Let's go back to the first slide, select the text boxes, and open the format pane. Go to the text options, and in the text effects tab, add a white glow of 150 points with a 0% transparency. And now the rest is pretty straightforward. The first two slides of my animation use that trick we just discussed. Then, the animation with the bursting words are simply extra slides with a morph transition active and a short transition duration, in our case 0.1 seconds. I use subtle tricks to enhance the animation. For example, notice that the letters burst in reading order to nudge the audience into reading the text. Also, notice that when the words burst, they do two changes of direction. They pop outside of the screen plane, but they also subtly return towards the initial location. This effect is called overshoot. Thanks for watching, don't forget to like, subscribe and share, and feel free to take a look at my other videos. I cover many other subjects like animation, design and 3D in PowerPoint. And don't forget, every creative day has a creative PowerPoint. See you next week, bye bye!